Hi all! Today we are going to learn how to make jack-o'-lantern basket. For this, the required materials are yarn. I am using Laura knitting cotton and fun fur yarn, crochet hook, needle, scissors, stitch marker, felt, thread, white pencil, and fabric glue. Now let's begin. First, you have to do chain 4. You can find my tutorial how to do chain stitch in the description box. Now, 15 DC in 4th chain from the hook. 1 2 Continue till you get 15 DCs. So totally there will be 16 DC in round 1. You don't join the rounds. You just mark first stitch of each round. This is a fun project which you can do at home. This is how the completed round 1 will look like. Round 2, single crochet in the next stitch. You can find single crochet tutorial in the description box. 2 single crochet in the next stitch. Then single crochet. 2 single crochet in the next stitch. Okay, 1. The same space. 1 more. 2 single crochet. Keep doing this till you reach the end of the round. Once again, you won't join the rounds. You will just mark first stitch of each round. You will have totally 24 single crochets in this round. This is how the completed second round will look like. Now let's begin the third round. In round 3, 2 single crochet, 1 more. You'll mark the first stitch. Single crochet in the next 3 stitches. Then 2 single crochets once again. 3 Repeat this till the end of the round. I'll meet you guys at the end of this round. end of this round. This is how the completed round will look like. It should have 30 single crochets. Now we are doing round 4. In this round, you will do single crochet in the next 9 stitches. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9. Now you will do 2 single crochets in the next stitch space. 1 in the same space, 1 more, 2. Now repeat this till you finish this round. We have reached the end of this round. You should have totally 33 single crochets in this round. Now let's start with round 5. In round 5, you will do single crochet in the next 10 stitches and 2 single crochet in the next stitch. We've done 10. Now 2 single crochet in this space. Now again 10 single crochet. Keep doing this till you reach the end of this round. So we've reached end of round 5. You should have totally 36 single crochets once you reach the end of this round. This is how the completed round will look like. Now round 6 to 10, you just have to do single crochet in each stitch around in loop. So you should have totally 36 stitch in each round 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It's up to you. You can increase or you can decrease the number of rounds. I'll meet you guys at the end of round 9. 10th round, you just have to repeat single crochet in each stitch. It's very simple, we just increasing. So once you've completed round 10, I'll meet you. Round 10. I'll remove the stitch marker. Last stitch. So this is how your basket will start to look like. Now we'll start decreasing so that we make a mouth for our basket. So in round 11, we'll start decreasing. We will do single crochet in the next 4 stitches. Now we'll do single crochet in the next 2 stitches and toggle. This is reduction. Hope you understood. I'll show you again. 4 single crochet in the next 4 spaces. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we are doing the decrease. Insert your hook, yarn over, insert again, yarn over, and yarn over through all the 3 loops. It becomes 1 single crochet. So that's how you do decrease. Now repeat this till you reach the end of this round. 4 single crochet and then 1 decrease and then 4 single crochet. Totally you should have 30 single crochet when you reach end of round 11. How it will start to look like once you have reached round 11. Now we are going to do round 12. In this, single crochet in each of the next 3 stitches. 1. I have added the stitch marker to the beginning of the first stitch. 2. 3. Now we'll do the decrease. Insert yarn over. Insert yarn over. Pull through all the 3 loops. Again, 3 single crochet. And then a decrease. I'll catch you guys at the end of this round. reached the end of this round, you should have totally 24 single crochet once you reach the end of this round. This is how it will look like. Now, round 13, you're going to do slip stitch in each of the stitch around. Insert yarn over, pull through. It will show like a V. I once again stitch marker in the first slip stitch. Insert your hook, pull yarn over. See, showing a V pattern. It makes a really beautiful pattern to the mouth of your basket. I will meet you guys at the end of this round. Remove the stitch marker and join with the first slip stitch and fasten off your yarn. You joined it. I've cut the yarn and I've just pulled it. Now, this is how it looks like. A pretty basket. Now, using a needle, I am just fastening off the thread so that it does not come off. Just trim off the excess yarn and just pull the yarn goes inside. Now this is how your basket will look like. Such a cute basket. Now we'll start making the handle. Since I am using fun fur yarn, it's very simple and it will be more beautiful. You have to chain as many as you want the length of your handle to be. I've chained 16. You can do more or you can do less. Then single crochet in the second chain from the hook. It's a bit difficult to find out the chains when you use fun fur yarn, but it's very easy. You can, once you try, you will be able to know how to do. So do this till you reach the end of the row. Single crochet in each chain space. I'll meet you guys at the end. So this is how it will look like. You just have to cut the excess yarn and fasten off the yarn. Now you have to sew the handle. This is how the handle will look like. Such a pretty handle. Now sew the handle to your basket. You can also use glue gun and stick, but I would prefer sewing. I'm using embroidery floss. So let's start sewing. It's very easy. Just your basic stitches and just secure tightly your handle. Trim off your excess yarn. thread. The next side, even you have to stitch in the same way. It's such a simple and easy project which you can do. Secure tightly your handle. Now, using felt, draw eyes, nose and mouth. You can even use googly eyes or you can just stitch them. But I am using here felt. I've drawn triangle shape for eyes and nose. Now you have to stick them using glue. You can use a fabric glue. It's that easy. Ta-da! Your jack-o'-lantern basket is complete. Hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. If you like, do give a thumbs up and do subscribe to my channel.